Today our topic is, what is this Linux repository based software management? Okay, so now I am quite sure that in the last two classes what we have tried to understand is how to install a Linux software. So we have looked at possibly four approaches. One was taking the source code and building the source code. The second approach was taking the executable, right, copying the executable, and whenever adding that executable's location to the path. That was the second approach. And the third approach, which we have discussed yesterday, was in the case of Red Hat machines, we said that we'll be using something called as RPM, and in the case of Debian machines, we said that we'll be using DPKJ, where we'll be getting RPM packages and Debian packages to install softwares. And RPM and Debian packages, as of now, was the easiest solution, because if you have an RPM, the commands are same no matter whatever software which you install. Are you in sync with whatever we have discussed so far? Okay, but still, in the case of RPM or Debian package, you still need to download that package. Download that package, right? Now, let me define something called as a repository. A Linux repository is a storage location from which our system can, install applications as well as operating system updates. Okay, so you can, if you want to delve one level deeper, right, each repository is collection of software hosted on remote server, okay, so that it can be used by many systems, okay, it can be used by many systems for installing or upgrading softwares, or you can call it as software packages. So so what is a Linux repository? Linux repository is a place. It is basically a remote server, some server, okay. Okay, so on this server, what they would have is, they would have a storage location. They would have some storage location, right? So in this storage location, what they would do is, they would try to maintain software packages, right, or OS updates. OS updates, all right. And now, any Linux system, any Linux system, from the convenience of their terminal, can get connected to this remote server, and they can install software. So this is Linux 2, Linux 1, and Linux 3. So your softwares will be present over here. You would be executing simple commands, right? So this one word commands will help you in installing the softwares. This is basically what it is. Right? So these repositories are hosted. If they are present inside your Linux machine, what is the difference between RPM package and this? Right? They're generally they are available outside, right? Now, by default, the repositories which we are using are exposed to the outside world, or they are accessible on a public internet. But your organization might want to might have an option of basically running their own a package manager, or they're running basically their own repository, okay, right? So basically, let us try to understand how this whole stuff works, right? So, but did we understood this concept of repository? Repository is like some common locations, right? So repositories are maintained by cloud providers, they are maintained by third parties, or even you and me can start a repository, okay? Now, let me start basically worrying about a popular packaging tool, which is yum. So yum is a popular, packaging or updating tool for managing software on Linux systems. Or to be very specific, if I had to define it in one word, it is basically a wrapper program for RPM, with enhancements. So when you use yum, you are internally using RPM, So if you remember, when you use RPM, what is that we need to do? We need to download the RPM package, and then we need to install it. But if you use yum, there is no need for you to download it, it will go and fetch it, right? So now yum is pre-installed, on RHEL machines, RHEL family machines like CentOS, Red Hat, even Amazon Linux. Amazon has its own flavor of Linux that also will use yum, even Fedora for that matter, So installing the package is very much simple, you have very, very simple commands, over here, but the whole thing which you need to understand is, you should be able to understand very basic commands of searching the software. You should be understanding the removing the software, and you should be able to do the updates. You should be able to get the information. So where is that we get all of this information, and where, how do we basically work about it? So let me go into Amazon and quickly create one Red Hat instance. Yum has been here for a while. This is a very old program. Let me add, because we'll be using Ubuntu also today. Red Hat. Good. So while this machine is launching, since I'll be using Ubuntu, after that, let me launch Ubuntu also, sir. Ubuntu. Next. All right. So since initially we are speaking about yum, let me connect to Red Hat. Okay. So for Red Hat machines, throughout this class, I have discussed this yesterday, we'll be using PowerShell to connect. Yeah. Right. So this will take some time. In the while it is taking time, let us understand certain stuffs over here. Okay. So sample commands. Okay, and by the way, yum stands for yellow dog updater. Okay, right. So we would have yum install package name. Okay, this will install the package. So similarly, we will have m erase package name. This will remove it. Okay, m search. Okay, package pattern. You can search for packages over here. Okay, m. There is one more interesting command called as dep list. Okay, and package name. Okay, so this command, let me write it down. Okay, so right, fine. Okay, this will install the package. This will remove the specified package. Okay. Searches the list of package names. Package names. Okay. From whatever repositories which they are basically connected to. Okay, right. And here it will list all the libraries, okay, and modules that the package depends on. Okay, here you might have other basic package also, right? Similarly, you would have m check update. Okay, so refreshes the local cache of yum database. Okay, so that you are having a dependency, you know the latest information, you know the latest information, right? So similarly, I'll be writing yum install. Yum install we have used, right? There is something called as yum reinstall. Okay, there is something called as yum update. I am not writing information about it. I'm quite sure you can understand this. Okay, and then yum upgrade, yum update package name. So yum update package name, what would it do? It would try to update the particular package. yum reinstall the package name will reinstall the package whatever you have tried to install. Yum upgrade. Okay. Upgrades. All packages installed in your system to latest release. To latest release. Okay. Right. Now, what basically happens over here is, okay, these are the commands. These are the commands which basically help you in installing the stuff. Okay. And all of these commands, okay, will be using one configuration file. One configuration file. Okay. So, yum configuration is located at c yum dot conf at c yum dot conf. Okay. So what it does is it provides system wide information. Okay. System wide configuration options. Options for yum. Okay. Right. Now let me log in into this machine. Okay. Okay. All right. Fine. Okay. So if there are any spelling mistakes, you correct it, guys. So I am human being, right? Whenever I type, you might get some typos. Okay. So now what I can basically do is whenever I want to, okay, work with yum. Okay. There are many things which you can basically do. Okay. One easier way for you to always, okay, work around with any commands by not remembering them, is, okay, there is a wonderful concept called as cheat sheet. There is a wonderful concept called as cheat sheet. I will go to the Google and then say yum cheat sheet. Are you seeing this? Are you getting this? Yeah. Don't even try to remember it. Take a printout of it, stick it to your desk, and you would be able to basically understand all the different stuffs. Am I clear on this, sir? There is no need for you to remember any command. Similarly, you will find Linux cheat sheet also. Okay. So, what I would recommend is. Recommendation, okay, use cheat sheet, refer here, and this cheat sheet is from Red Hat itself, nothing like that. So are you seeing, it is trying to tell that if you want to do yum queries, okay, I have something called as yum help, sudo yum help. So are you saying it has given you all the options? It has given you all the options. Yeah. And then list. Sudo yum list available. Okay. What are the lists that are available? This will be a very huge list. This will take some time. Okay. Okay, because what is happening is it is going into the repositories and it is finding out what are the different packages which you have, which are available to you. Okay. And then this is much easier. This will try to tell you what are the packages that are installed on your system. Am I clear on this? These are the packages. What are the packages that are installed on your system? Okay, good. Okay, I am not going to give you any command screenshots today. Is it looking okay, sir? Is it looking okay? Right. So what we would do is, let us try about a use case now. Okay. So case study. Okay. Install Java 8 using Yum. Okay, or let me call it as using install JDK 8, or to be very specific, I'm calling it as open JDK 8. So in this, is there any search command, sir? Are you finding any search command? Okay. Yeah, there is something called a search. Yeah, and here he has given you an example of Yum search Samba. So let us see if we can search for Java. Sudo Yum search. Okay, I don't know Java, so I'm just writing JDK. Are there some information that we got? Yeah. And now you want to install JDK 8. Okay. So let us assume this. Okay. Sudo yum info. And let me try doing this. Are you getting information? Are you getting information, sir? Okay. So what are the commands which you would be executing? Sudo yum search JDK. And then whenever you do that, you would find packages. Okay. So out of these packages, you will find whatever is the right choice for me. Whatever is the right choice for me. Okay. Let us assume that I have found this one as the right choice. Okay. Java. Okay. This one. Now, what is that I will do? I'll try to find out information about it. Okay. So do you want a runtime environment or a developer environment? Are you seeing this? I want a development environment. JDK. I have not asked for JRE. So I'm interested in this. Okay, because I'm interested in development environment. Okay, now what I would try to do is, once I know that this is a package name which I have to install, okay, I can basically save. I can basically query for the information. Okay, so let me try to put that image preview dot slash images slash what is it? Linux 108. Yeah, right. Fine. Linux 108.png. Right. Now, after that, I'll be trying sudo yum info, and then whatever the package name which I have identified. So for example, what was the package name which I have identified? I've identified my package name would be this. Sudo yum info and this. So is it trying to tell you what is the version of the software which you are trying to install? Is it trying to tell you release? Is it trying to tell you where you are trying to basically install? And now, if you want to install this package, it is very simple now. What you have to basically do is, okay, sudo yum install and the package name. Okay, right. Sudo yum install package name and click on enter. So whenever you do this, it will try to tell you that these are all the packages and the dependencies that would be installed. Do you want to continue? Just click on Y. Okay. Open JDK. What was the name which you have used? It's okay. I'll copy paste it later. Okay. Now if I ask you to install Java 11, will you be able to do that? Okay. Now if I ask you to basically install Java 11, will you be able to do that? Okay. Yes or no, sir? Okay. Let us go step by step, sir. Don't worry what will happen if the software is not found. That is my headache, right? Worry about what I have covered. Okay. Now, let me try to search for something called as Python. So are you finding different Pythons over here? Yeah. So if you want to install Python, can you find out the info from this variables, info from this package names and install Python? Yes or no, sir? Okay. Can we or not? Okay, good. Or the other thing which you can easily do is using yum to install Python. You would get some Google stuff. There is no need for you to remember any commands. Okay, so what is he trying to tell? He is asking you to execute some commands. You execute these commands and then you would be able to install Python. Okay. There are many ways of basically getting the stuff done. There are many ways of getting the stuff done. Okay. So the command for installing Python is something like this. Okay. Whatever it is, I'm not worried about Python. Similarly, let us assume you want to install Tomcat. Okay. So what is that you would do? Sudo yum search Tomcat. Okay, it says no packages found. So if there are no packages that are found, one easiest thing what I would end up doing is using yum to install Tomcat. Am I getting this? Yeah. Go and look through the documentations. You can basically find out installation commands of any softwares. Here we are not trying to understand every Linux software's installation, but whenever we look at this command, now do we understand what happens with this command? Okay, so in this command, he is trying to give you multiple package names. Let it be. Now if you want to install Tomcat, he is trying to tell that this is a command. This is a command. Okay, so whenever you are able to find the softwares, one stuff is you can basically search. Okay, but the other easier stuff is go to the Google and then try it out. There is one more thing which you are expected to do, or which is actually something which you might end up doing, right? So install logstash. Okay, let me try to do this. Sudo yum search logstash. So what is happening over here? There is no logstash found. There is no logstash found. Okay. Now, in the case of certain softwares, right? This is Linux has repository already added. Okay, so in your Linux machine, the repository for OpenJDK is already added. Linux has Linux doesn't have the repository where you have a software. Doesn't have a repository where the software is distributed. So now what is happening is Logstash is present in a different repository, and that repository information is not available. Not available. Don't worry about what Logstash is, sir. Okay, worry about Logstash is some software you're asked to install it, but the problem is that software is not available in your Linux system because it is not added to your remote repository. Okay, now is there any way that I can add a remote repository? There is definitely a way. Okay, let us look out how to add the remote repository. Okay, so that is this use case. In this use case, what we would do is we would try to add a new repository to your existing M repositories. Okay, so for that, let me try to go into one folder on your Red Hat machine. Okay, so let me become a root user for some time. Cd etc em, and in this, okay, we have not used anything. Okay, fine. Let me try to do that. Okay, install Logstash. Okay, so in etc, okay, my bad, in etc, if you see, you will have a folder over here which is called as m.repos.d. Sorry, seeing over here, you will have a folder which is m.repos.d. Okay, so in this m.repos.d, are you seeing some files? Okay, so cd etc m.repos.d, and here let me do ll. So are you seeing three files over here? Okay, so any file with dot repo definition over here, which ends with dot repo, means that it is a information about your repository. It is information about your repository. Okay, so if you want to add a new repository, you can also add the file. But let us look at existing repository, Red Hat. So are you seeing there is a lot of stuff that is being added over here? So this is the Red Hat repository. This is the Red Hat repository. Okay, let me take the screenshot so far. Okay, so get into this folder. Okay, so if you want to add, you can add repositories over here. You can add repositories over here, right? So now in Linux, in M, okay, we can navigate to what? Etc repos m.repos.d. m.repos.d. And in this folder, whatever we see are the repositories which your Linux machine knows. Okay, so what are the Linux repositories which your system will know? If you want to understand that, this is basically what it is. Now, if I want to expand my Linux system's knowledge on a repository, okay, then there are certain case which you need to follow. Certain case which you need to follow. Okay, so if you want to define, if you want to add a repo, create a file with dot repo extension in this folder. In this folder, and add the information which looks like, okay, so this is the information how it would look like. Okay, it would have what is your repository's name, repo name. Okay, so name is equals to repository name, and here you would have something called as mirror list. Okay, so this mirror list will have, okay, some URL, HTTP URL, okay, where you would have accessible mirror list, okay, and then you would have something called as base URL. Okay, so base URL is not mandatory, it might be hash. If it has hash, it might be commented. Okay, and then generally it would have GPG check. Okay, so it is to verify your repository. It is to verify your repository. Okay, so here if you have put it as 1, it will verify. 0, it will not verify. Okay, and then to verify the correctness of this GPG, we will have GPG key. We'll have GPG key. This is what you need to do. Now here I want to add logstash. Now what logstash says is, okay, I don't have a repository, you don't have a repository, so what is that we need to do? Okay, let's add, okay, information about a new repository to our Red Hat system. Okay, how do I do that? I'll get into yum repo, and over here I'm creating a file which is called as elastic.repo. Okay, if you give any other extension, it will not work out. Okay, and in this elastic.repo, if you go into documentation over here, he has already given you what has to be added: name, base URL, GPG check, right? It is enabled, auto refresh is enabled, all of this, blindly copy this. Here he has given a base URL, not a mirror list. Am I clear on this? Once I do this, okay, create a new file called as what? Elastic.repo in etc m.repos.d. Okay, with following info, right? So generally whenever you're installing softwares, you would get this information. It is not a very rocket science to get this information, but if you want to understand what is happening internally after that, that is what we are trying to do. And now I have done this, right? Now let me basically go and say yum search logstash. Do I find logstash now? Do I find logstash now? How? Because now my Red Hat machine knows about a new repository. My Red Hat machine knows about a new repository. Okay, and that repository is basically information which we have added over here. Now if I want to install, I would be saying yum install logstash, and I'm giving hyphen y because I don't want to answer that question, do you want to continue, this will download and all of that stuff. Now do we understand this concept of, right, 110 and 111? Let me add 110 and 111, right? So 110 and 111. Okay, right. So tomorrow your company might have their own local repository which is hosted by them in their organization. Then this URL which you are trying to add might be your organizational URL. It might not be exposed to the outside world. Okay, you can create repositories also. Okay, but that is a beyond the scope of whatever I discuss, right? So if you are interested, you can basically see how can I create a repository on my Linux system. Okay, there are some softwares which can help you in basically creating repositories. Okay, so if someone gives you this information about your repository, now can you add that repository into Red Hat system and install softwares? Now the same thing happens on apt. The same thing happens on apt-get also, right? So now M is for Red Hat machines, apt, okay? Apt or aptitude is a tool for managing packages on Ubuntu based systems or Debian based systems, to be very specific. Now, okay, what is the easier way to know what are the command lines? Apt cheat sheet, yes or no, sir? Okay, do I get the cheat sheet? Okay, right. So I don't want you to refer any commands, refer here for apt based cheat sheet. Okay, commands will be different. So if you go into apt based, how do you basically upgrade, right? So how do you search? Okay, for searching there is something called as apt cache, right? So you have to go through these commands. I am not going to speak about each and every command, then that is not possible, right? So I'll be doing the same thing. Okay, so let's install Java 8, okay, in Ubuntu. So what is the case of Java 8? Repo, repository, already added. Okay, in the case of Java, the repository is already added. So what is that I would do? Let me go into Ubuntu system. Okay, so in Ubuntu system, whenever I basically execute sudo apt-get update, I am not doing anything. I am updating the definitions, right? These are all repository locations. These are all repository locations. Okay, now if I have to search for Java, what is that I would do? Sudo apt-cache search JDK. I want you to give it a try on these commands. Okay, I will not even make these commands. I'll look into the image and type it for yourself. Okay, right. So this is the command. Okay, now let me save it. Okay, I'm using the same thing because you can do the similar stuff. Okay, right. And then after that, what is that I'd be doing? I'll be finding out what is the package. So sudo apt install or apt get install, both are same. Open JDK hyphen 8 hyphen JDK hyphen 1. I'm giving hyphen Y because I don't want this machine to ask me stupid questions. Okay, if I don't give this, it will ask me for a question saying that I am going to do all of this. Do you want me to continue? If I give hyphen Y, it will not do that. Okay, I am not going to do anything beyond that. Okay, right. Okay, now you find it for yourself. How do I find information? I've already shared the cheat sheet, right? And I'm quite sure you guys will be able to do that. Okay, so 112, 113, and the last one of the day. Let's install logstash. Okay, repository not added. Repository not added. Okay, so we need to add the repository. So let us see what happens. Okay, come on, man. We are running out of time and this is taking. Okay, so while I can do one more thing, right? I can have a Linux is a multi-user session. Let me copy this. And while the stuff is happening on this machine, I'll log in into this machine. All right. Okay, good. Now, basically what I want to do is, I want to become a root user for some time. And let me get into etc apt. Okay. So in this apt, are you seeing sources.list? Are you seeing this file called as sources.list? In this sources.list, you can add the repository information. There you have to create a file. Here you have to add a line. Here you have to add a line. Okay. So let us see what we basically do. I'll basically open sources.list. Okay. These are all the lines, and these lines will tell information about your repository. Now over here, what I would do is I'd go to the documentation. Okay. And are you seeing this line? This command internally does the same thing. It adds to the end of the file. Okay. That too, if it doesn't exist. Okay. Now, after this, I have to sudo apt-get update. You have to do this. In the case of Red Hat, it is not required, but in here, you have to update the packages, update the package definitions. Okay. So it is trying to tell that, okay, I cannot do this because you have to verify some signature. Okay. That is because of signing key. Okay. If you don't have the valid keys, your verification will fail. In the case of repository information in Red Hat, we have given GPG key path. That's the reason why it has not asked. Now let me do sudo apt-get update. Is it done? Now let me, if I try to search sudo apt-cache search logstash. So are you seeing logstash? Okay. Now if I want to install logstash, it is sudo apt-get or apt install logstash hyphen y. Don't worry about what this logstash is. I am trying to tell you the case where your repository is already added and repository is not added. Are we clear on this, sir? Okay. This I am not even writing the commands. You find it out for yourself. Okay. Refer here. Okay. All right. Install from package repositories. So in the case of Ubuntu and in the case of Red Hat, the places where you have your repository definitions, are we clear on this? Etc yum.repos.d in the case of Red Hat. Okay. And in the case of Ubuntu, it will be, what is the file name? Etc apt sources.list. Okay. So if you want to add a file, you can do it like this also. Okay. You can create a folder called as list.d and then do it, but it is not required. It is one line. Why do you want to have a file? Okay. Clear on this, sir? So now whenever I am searching for software, okay, can you do it? And remember, I have not used uninstalling the software and updating the software. I have given you cheat sheets. So can you update softwares and uninstall softwares? Okay. Try updating the software and uninstalling the software. Will you guys do it? Look into cheat sheets. You will find the commands. Yeah, good, sir. So I'll stop it at that.
Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe our channel and click on bell icon.